In the past years, Mr. Ognjan Ivanov and academic Borisov accomplished some experiments regarding acousto-electronic interactivities. A surface acoustic wave propagating along a piezoelectric substance is accompanied by an electric field having both a longitude and transverse component. The electric field which accompanies the wave is capable of interacting with charged carriers in the semiconductor in the vicinity of the piezoelectric crystal. The depth of the penetration of the field in the semiconductor is dictated both by the acoustic wavelength and the Debye length. During these experiments, Ognjan Ivanov and academic Borisov found a new effect that they called surface photocharge effect. Shortly, this effect is described as follows. The interaction of any solid with an electromagnetic field induces an alternating potential difference with the same frequency as the frequency of the incident field. Experimentally, the potential difference between the irradiated sample and the common electric ground of the system is measured. An important feature of the surface photocharge effect is its significant dependence from the specific properties of the irradiated sample. This fact reveals vast opportunities for rapid and contactless analysis of solids, liquids and gases. Compared to other similar effects, the surface photocharge effect is characteristic for all kinds of solids, and this makes it very interesting from scientific as well as from practical point of view.
Professor Borisov was also director of the International School of Condensed Matter Physics, which holds every 2 years in Varna, and this was in difficult period of
cult
when the contacts between Western and Eastern experts, leaders of condensed matter physics, these contacts were very difficult, and Professor Borisov ensured, first of all, quiet, very good contacts, and also world level of scientific lectures, world level for that period. So my feeling is that he was very wise director of this school.
Independent faculty of physics detached from the old faculty of physics and mathematics in 1963 at the time when Milko Borisov was dean.
In 1959 he became a vice director. In 1962 a dean and vice rector. In 1972 a director of the United Center of Physics.
Section of the Bulgarian Academy of Sciences reorganized by the law since 21st April 1972 became United Centers. All units, university and academic institutes and laboratories on the field of physics entered in the Center of Physics.
In general, I would like to say that Professor Borisov was not only interested in electronics, he was a very much scientist as in the solid state physics. He also was director of the Center of Physics, and as a director he has a very great contribution to this whole development of Bulgarian physics in those years. And now Bulgarian physics is one of the very well developed branches of Bulgarian Academy of Sciences. And of course, partly this is due to the contribution of academic Borisov.
To conclude, I would like to call attention to the fact that Milko Borisov, who has worked both at the university and in the academy, has clearly seen the need of connection between the two institutes, created to strengthen the relations between both scientific groups. United Centers had a short lifespan. I believe that integration carried out in a way useful to both sides and without wasting the existing strong scientific potential of the Academy would be in the spirit and in complete agreement with the positions and beliefs of the great scientist and extraordinary man Milko Borisov.
Milko Borisov became director of the Center of Physics from 1973 up to 1988. After that, all scientific centers were closed down.